If you're watching this video, you most likely heard about this thing called an NFT. After Beeple, a famous digital artist, sold one of his images for a whopping $69 million, the hype is all over the place. I had no idea what an NFT is, nor did I know how to create one. So I set out to a little challenge. I want to find out as much as I can about NFTs, smart contracts, Ethereum, and decentralized apps, and program my own NFT crypto collectible in only 3 days and release it on OpenSea. This is day one. I know that a lot of NFTs run on the Ethereum blockchain, but I have no idea what running on the blockchain actually means. So, first things first, I have to find out what Ethereum actually is and how it works. Ethereum is the second largest cryptocurrency by market capitalization after Bitcoin, and it is a blockchain-based software platform. You can send and receive Ethereum globally without any third party actually doing the transfer. But there is more to Ethereum than there is to other blockchains like the Bitcoin blockchain. Ethereum is able to run programs, so-called smart contracts. These little programs are not run on one specific server, but inside of the blockchain. So while Ethereum is built upon the same technology Bitcoin is built on, a blockchain, the idea behind Ethereum is to decentralize other kinds of applications and services, from social media networks to more complex financial agreements. So we have this big network of computers at our disposal that we can use to run programs on. But how can I create a program for it? And how can people access it? In the long run, Ethereum apps should be everywhere. At least that's the vision. So instead of talking to one server, apps from the App Store would talk to the Ethereum blockchain. But how far into this future are we already? Researching further, I learned about decentralized apps, or dApps. dApps use the blockchain as the storage for their main data. I found dApps for exchanging different cryptocurrencies and taking out loans. There are also whole games or virtual worlds built which use the Ethereum blockchain as their main knowledge base. But your browser can't just connect to the Ethereum blockchain. To connect to the Ethereum blockchain, you need something called a wallet. Your Ethereum wallet is your access portal to the Ethereum network. It stores your account on the Ethereum blockchain in the form of a private key. Everyone who has access to that private key has access to your wallet, which means access to all your data and your Ether.
There are a lot of different wallets out there, but in order to interact with dApps, one wallet is used a lot: MetaMask. MetaMask is a wallet that you can integrate into your web browser via a plugin or download onto your phone and use the browser integrated inside the MetaMask app to enable websites to interact with the blockchain. This is used by dApps running inside of your browser to send transactions into the blockchain or read data from the blockchain. To interact with Ethereum with your own website, there is a JavaScript library called Web3JS, which can utilize MetaMask or any other wallet integrated into your browser.
So, a decentralized app is an app using some kind of wallet to connect to the Ethereum network, in which it has stored some smart contracts to run transactions, store data, and read data from the blockchain. But there is a problem. Writing data into the blockchain is not for free. There is something called a gas fee, and for all memory-intensive calculations and for storing data inside the blockchain, the initiator needs to pay the fee for the gas that is used. Gas fees rise with the amount of transaction being processed inside of the network. So you can see here how gas fees have risen over the last couple of years. And because there is a lot going on right now inside of the network, gas is really expensive these days. But that's a problem for future Daniel, I guess. Next, I need to find out how I can develop smart contracts. I have no idea how the development environment or a development cycle looks like for the blockchain.
So what I found out is that smart contracts run on the EVM, the Ethereum Virtual Machine, and are developed in a programming language called Solidity. Solidity is an object-oriented programming language for writing smart contracts.
Time to learn a new programming language. How hard can it be?
There are different development environments for Solidity. But one that popped up over and over again was Truffle JS, a JavaScript development environment to build smart contracts. And since I want to develop a web app that interacts with the blockchain later as well, I figured that using JavaScript for everything would be a good idea. Another puzzle piece is Ganache. Ganache is a simulated Ethereum blockchain on your computer. Ganache helps to test your smart contracts locally without the need to deploy it to the Ethereum mainnet or one of its testnets.
So the first thing I need to do is to install Truffle.js. npm install Truffle. The next thing is to initialize a new Truffle project. Truffle init. So I started Visual Studio Code here, and let's have a look at the initial content of an empty Truffle project. The first folder you see is the contracts folder. You see a migrations.sol file, which is the first Solidity file we see here. After that, we have a migrations folder where we have different migration scripts. As far as I understand it, the migrations contract and the migration scripts work together in order to get our smart contracts onto the blockchain. And we have a test folder, which we can use to write unit tests for our smart contracts, which will come in handy later, I guess. And then another file that's specific to this Truffle project is the Truffle config.js. As far as I understand it, it's used to connect the project with the local blockchain and maybe later with other blockchains we want to deploy to. So the next thing we need is to install Ganache, our local blockchain to test our smart contracts. The easiest way to do this is to use homebrew, at least if you are on macOS. Brew install --cask Ganache. So the first time you start Ganache, it looks like this. To be honest, I played around with it a little bit before actually recording this part of the video. I learned that creating a workspace and actually connecting it to your smart contract project, your Truffle project, is a smart way to do, because this way you will keep the accounts on the blockchain static and you don't need to reconnect your MetaMask to Ganache every time you start Ganache. So we go new workspace Ethereum, we give it a name, add project, navigate to your Truffle.js folder, select the Truffle config.js and click open. Save workspace. Here you go. This is your private Ethereum blockchain on your machine. You see there are 10 different accounts on your blockchain. Each of these accounts got a balance of 100 Ethereum. So next, let's connect Ganache to MetaMask. So I have the MetaMask Google Chrome plugin installed on my computer. As you can see here, I'm connected to the Ethereum mainnet. So the first thing we need to do is connect our MetaMask wallet to our local blockchain. In order to do that, we click here, select settings, go down to networks and click on add network. We enter a network name. We enter the new RPC URL, HTTP localhost 7545. The chain ID is 1337. Currency symbol is Ethereum. Safe. Now my MetaMask wallet is connected to my Ganache blockchain. So the next thing we want to do is to connect our MetaMask wallet to one of our accounts in the Ganache local blockchain. To do that, we click on the key icon, we copy the private key, click on the avatar, import account, and paste the private key here. Click import, voila, we have an account with 100 Ethereum. In order to show that this actually works, let's send one Ethereum to the second account on our local blockchain. So we need to copy the public address, send, paste, one Ethereum, next, confirm. And here we go. We see that the balance of the first account is reduced to 99 Ethereum and the balance of the second account is now 101 Ethereum. That was day one. I learned a lot about the whole Ethereum ecosystem and I set up my development environment. Tomorrow I will implement my first ever smart contract. If you want to follow my journey, please consider subscribing. Thanks to all my patrons for helping running this channel. And I see you in one of my other videos. As always, have a lot of fun, coders.